And welcome to Player vs. Player. My name is Cole Wall. And today, we are going to be talking about Claude Giroux versus, we'll leave it as a mystery for now. So here's some key points. This is Player vs. Player, so you'll get to see the other players. So let's talk about Claude. Claude is a good player. You know, he's had that one breakout year and... Oh, can you guys... I'm covering up my phone. He had that one breakout year and he did pretty awesome. You know, there were some areas he could improve in and stuff. Like, he's kind of streaky, I think, a bit. And he has no cups, man. He has nothing. He has no awards. He needs to... But awards sometimes don't matter, you know? Sometimes you don't really need awards. Just awards are just to shut up critics, right? And he's a good player, you know. He works his butt off. He gets stuff done. He's good at skating. But what I like about Claude is his mental, his hockey instincts. He is like great with that stuff. You know, he's got great hockey senses. He knows how to shoot. He's got great accuracy. He can snipe that puck if he wanted to. And he's got hockey sense. Like, he knows right angles to bounce it off. He knows how to set up good plays. He's very smart with the puck and stuff. Well, I'd say not so smart because his plus minuses aren't that good, but he can improve in lots of areas. Some of the downturns of Claude Giroux is, I think he's not that tough. He's not that tough. He's a bit of a, well, in my opinion, a wimp. And he gets, not as much as Crosby, because at the time Crosby was complaining about Claude Giroux, and Claude Giroux knocked his glove over in that Pittsburgh vs. Philadelphia playoff series. That was hilarious, and he was so mad. So, yeah. And, so Claude, I could see him being good. And, yeah. Yeah, he's a great player. He works great. I there's nothing really bad you can say about Claude. He's just an average Joe, though. He's almost at... I wouldn't call him a superstar yet, but he could be there one day, maybe. I would say he would be like... I don't know what category kind of put him in. Not superstar, not all-star. Maybe just star. I'll have a category of players later, but I would put him a star, not superstar or all-star yet, but you know, he's played all-star games before and he's appeared in them. He's alright, you know? I can't say anything about him. He's very good and I can't find anything bad to say about him. I got like a couple more minutes in before I start talking about stats. Yeah. He's great, and he can do everything. But he's not that really versatile, I think. I think he could be more versatile. Like, if we could get him to play left wing or stuff, or he can, like, play more better defense, maybe. Maybe step up his defensive game. Be a little more versatile. And maybe he'd be recognized more as a player, but he's solid, you know? He's alright. I kinda don't mind him. You know, he's not that bad. And everything I hope goes out good for Claude, you know? One disadvantage of Claude, though, is I'm gonna bring that topic back up. He's not tough, you know? He's gonna get hurt a lot. He got that concussion that one year, and I see a lot of more injuries coming for Claude. Like, he's gonna get banged up a lot, you know, and he doesn't get the recognition you think he does. He doesn't, like, nobody, like, he had that one hot season, and he's kind of dirty. He was like Tim Tebow, pretty much. He just disappeared, and I would consider him the Tim Tebow of hockey, because I like Tim Tebow, and, yeah. I played with him in NHL 13 once. I traded Taylor Hall for him. I don't know why I did that. Well, the reason why is I don't like Hall getting injured all the time. But then, if you come think of it, Clad gets injured often. He had that one rough start to that one season. I'll have to look at it again. And, yeah. I think Clad could use, like, a partner. Someone, some good players to play with him. I think they should put Braden Shen to get there. And here are Claude Giroux's stats. So, Claude Giroux did pretty awesome in the QMJHL. 48 goals one season. That's pretty impressive in 63 games. Like, he's terrible. And he's got 64 assists, 112 points, 49 penalty minutes, and plus 12. But then, what happened here when he went to the AHL here? He didn't do so good. He only got 5 games. He probably got hurt that year. At least he had 1 goal, though, but his plus minus was terrible. And then he went back to the QMHL, played 55 games, got 38 goals. That's just pretty awesome. And then Flyers, his debut was 7-0-8. 2 games played, 0-0-0. But he had a negative 2. That's not so good. So then they took him to the AHL. And he did alright. But I think his best season here. Like, he really does have no. He doesn't put up big numbers. Like, I wish he would. He doesn't contribute that much to the team. And those are some weak totals. I've seen some players get more. And the beginning of the season, he's not going to be. He has a total of 123 goals, 272 assists, 395 points. So that's pretty good for that year, but he does rank up on the point side, though. If you look at his assists, he's more of a playmaker. Like, he's not their heavy goal-scoring machine, but he's playmaker. He'll set up goals, or he'll score if he needs to. So he's a bit versatile in that area. He needs to switch that around, and sometimes he's got to take the goal for himself, and he can contribute to that team way more than he is right now. There's so much potential for him. I could see him winning one award, maybe, in the league. Because he needs to shut up the critics. Yeah, I'm just sorry about that, guys. Anyway, everything looks pretty good. We played 1 year in the DHL. Now, who is he versing? Let's see if you guys can guess. Okay, he's from Russia. Evgeny Malkin! Malkin is awesome. He can dance, split D for you. He's got high octane. He's got fast. He's youth. He's young. And he's got so much potential in him. He's got some awards for you. He's led you to the Stanley Cup. And he's pretty much kept your season alive. Well, Crosby is like the king of the team, but you can't forget about Malkin. Malkin contributed a lot. Yeah. Anyway, it was pretty awesome. You know, I enjoy Malkin watching him. Like, I can see him splitting D more. I would like to see him split D more often and get more breakaways and stuff. Yeah, which is pretty awesome. Look at that one fan there. And Malkin and Sally too. Malkin, all around good player. You know, nothing really bad you can say about him either. Some of the downsides to Malkin is, again, he has a bit of injury problems, but not recently, but that 1 year he missed a lot of games, and he does have a little bit of injury history with him, which I could see that biting him when he gets older, and that might come back up his alley when he gets older. Very quiet so far this season. I haven't heard that much of him, news of him or yet, but I've only been watching Oiler games, and I barely keep up the statistics anymore. I used to do that a lot, but I could improve in that area. like a lot. Is that still recording? Okay, good, it's still recording. Yeah. Okay, good. So yeah, I'm trying to dig up some dirt on Malkin. Maybe I can find stuff. Evgeny Malkin. So, you know, you can't say anything about him. Born Russian. Arguably, he could be on the top list of good Russians. He's age 28, 6 foot 391 centimeters. He's a center. He shoots left. Second overall. He's got a website. Yeah. You can't say really anything bad about these guys. You know, they're solid players, but I have to say Malkin might win this, because Malkin has kind of stepped up and reached his full potential, though. I don't see Giroux reaching anymore. I mean, he's going to be quiet and stuff. And I don't know, you guys can decide here. I'll make some key points. Giroux. I think Giroux might be better at face-offs than Malkin. Malkin's more versatile, though. He can play better on the wing. If you need Malkin to play on the wing, he can play. Malkin's a power play player. Giroux could kind of work on his power play, and I can't say anything bad about these guys, you know? They're both legends, and I see Malkin coming on top and having a better career in the future than Claude Giroux. Claude Giroux he's got one quarter left of his potential and he's done. I don't see Giroux developing anymore. Either being very quiet and stuff like that, I don't know, statistics should be coming up pretty soon. I gave myself 5 minutes and 30 seconds to talk about each player. Malkin does have some pretty sweet hands, though, you have to mention that. And Giroux, he's got decent, but I think Malkin's got better. And I wish Malkin would use them more often, though. I think of memories. I used to watch so much hockey and then kind of got away from it, and then yeah. I used to follow statistics like 24/7. Well, here are Malkin's statistics. Malkin, in his debut, in his full first season, he played 78 games with 33 goals. Look what he averages, except for this. Well, what happened that year? Oh, that was a half year. He must have got hurt that year. He's only played 2 full seasons. That's not that good. Only 2 full seasons, you know. See, he's been hurt. I'm not even sure if Giroux has played. I think Giroux only played 1 full season. I have to go back. But, yeah, Malkin already has 246 goals and 403 assists. And he's got a pretty good plus minus, he's had for some years. Right now he's minus 4. And yeah, Malkin also has 454 penalty minutes, and Giroux, I think, has less. So yeah, and I hope to see you guys again. Comment what player you want me to talk about next, and player versus player, and maybe I'll do highlights. Go follow OK Hockey Edits on Instagram, and on Vine, go follow OMG, all capitals, Hockey Highlights, all lowercase. You won't regret following them. And make sure to check out NHL Confessions on Instagram. And yeah, everything's going to be great. And I hope you guys all enjoy. And yeah. So subscribe if you really enjoy. Tell me how I can improve the show. Maybe I could do a little bit of watching videos before I do it. I think that's what I'm going to start doing now. Might add a little bit of clips. And so just tell me how I can improve this show here. This is just my first one. This is just a tryout and stuff. And I couldn't find really good information. So see you guys and enjoy.